Hey y'all, this is Amber with thelovegal.com and youtube.com/thelovegal and lawofattractionblueprint.com. And in this video, I'm going to be telling you how I change the outcome of any situation. Maybe it's something that you're trying to manifest. It can be something that has already happened, but you don't like the outcome of how it ended, or you just want to change the dynamic of a certain situation. Before we get started, go ahead and hit that like button and hit that subscribe button and turn on your notification bell to get notified when I drop new content. If you are here to learn how to change the outcome of any situation, it could be relationships, friendships, job situation, it could be income situations. If you want to know how to change the outcome of it using one law, go ahead and hit that like button. And before we get started, I want to check the temperature of my viewers. So how are you feeling today? Go ahead and drop an emoji in the comments of how you're feeling today. And please, all I ask is please spare me with an eggplant emoji if that's how you're feeling today. Please keep that to yourself, okay? And that goes for the little splash one too, okay? We don't need to know all that. All right. On my channel, I typically talk about the law of attraction. I've talked about the law of action. I've talked about the law of expectation. But in today's video, I'm going to be talking about the law of assumption. The law of assumption pretty much states that what you assume to be true will turn out to be true. If you assume something will turn out positive, it will turn out positive. If you assume something will turn out negative, it will turn out negative. And I'm going to give a few examples of what I notice of how things in my life have been altered by the way that I think. And it sounds crazy, but I really had to sit with myself and think about it. I was like, oh my goodness, I'm controlling everything in my life based on how I think about the situation. But if you are new here, I do have law of attraction help me manifest tools. I have an ebook that you can download today instantly. I don't care what time it is. That goes along with my law of attraction guided scripting worksheets. Everything is going to be linked in my description, and you can also click on the testimonial page in my description as well. I also have a discounted bundle for today. It's all 10 scripting worksheet packets, my ebook, there is my raise my vibration audio, a couple cheat sheets in there. There's some good stuff in there, and today you can get it for $25 USD, instant download. But anyway, I had to learn that everything, and I do mean everything, is me spit out. From my friendships, the relationships I have with people, my finances, even day-to-day routine stuff. I'm gonna explain what I mean when I say everything is me spit out. It's almost as if everything in my life is a mirror to my thoughts and my energy. I'm going to give an example right quick. Make sure you watch this video to the end because I'm going to be dropping jewels all throughout this video. So I'm going to give an example just so you can understand what I'm saying if you're new to this concept. It's going to be pretty much a contrast. I was going out of town and I was going to see a friend, and I remember being so excited to see my friend. I was excited to spend time with her. Like I'm lit. I am so happy on the way. I'm just thinking about like how fun it's gonna be and how excited I am. And I'm just full of good energy. I'm just thinking about all the good times we're about to have. We're about to go get some good food. It's her birthday. It's just a good time. And so I'm pretty much consumed in those thoughts for a good 2 hours at least. When I got there and I see her, it was very much so magnetic. She gave the hugest hug. Like, she was so excited and so happy that I was there. And you could be like, well, she could have just been happy to see you too, bitch. I mean, girl, y'all friends. So, like, maybe that's just what it was. Let me tell you. It was a couple months later. She had came to see me. I remember I woke up that day, and I remember I had to go and get her. And I don't know, I just didn't have the best energy, and I was just like, I was in a blah mood. I was in a super blah mood. And when I finally saw her, her energy was the same towards me. There was no excitement, there was no nothing. And in my head, I was like, I remember thinking when I saw her, I was like, this is like completely different than how I saw her a couple months ago. Like, it was no excitement, it was just like a, hey. Like, you know what I'm saying? So I was like, oh, that's confusing. But now, understanding the law of assumption, it doesn't matter how she was thinking about me. It's the energy I put into our situation in that moment. It's how I thought about her. And that is going to be reflected back to me. There are so many other situations that I can just go on and on and on and on about it. But I had to really sit with myself. I was like, yo, this is so true. So if you're trying to fix the situation, or you want somebody to be a little more happy when they see you, start thinking about them in the way that you want them to think about you. Like I said, everything in your life is you spit out. And I want you to take some time to really think about that. Think about certain situations that have happened to you. Think about the people in your life. Think about your rocky relationships. Think about your stable relationships. What is the difference? What are your thoughts towards those situations? Do you have stable thoughts? Are you grateful for your stable relationships? Do you give side eyes to your rocky relationships, the people in your life you're not really sure about? But how you think about that person and how you think about that situation is going to be reflected back to you. And this goes with anything. You are the co-creator of your own life. I'm just going to give an example. I was laying in bed with my boyfriend one night, and I remember, I was like, should I wait to transfer this money to my account? I said, watch, as soon as I transfer this money, some more gonna come in, watch. And that's exactly what happened. I transferred the money, put my phone down, I went to the bathroom, came back, more money had came in. I know I've said this twice already, but everything in your life is you pushed out. Now, how do you fight through negative thoughts? Because what you assume to be true is going to be true. You have to reprogram your subconscious mind into thinking this is natural. If you want to alter the outcome of whatever situation it is, you have to make your mind and your subconscious think this is natural. And how I do it through affirmations, saying stuff like, oh, I love making back-to-back payments. Oh, I love making $75 in 4 minutes. I love making $100 in an hour. Even if it's not true yet, it will become true because you're constantly feeding that to your subconscious mind through repetition. And your subconscious mind doesn't know what's real or what's fake. So why not feed it what you want to be true? You are the co-creator of your life. So you have to make things seem as natural as possible. And another way to do that is visualize how you want things to be. Feed your subconscious with positive affirmations of how you want it to be. See it. Imagine it. Imagine the outcome that you want it to be. Imagine it here first. But to answer the question to this video, how do you change the outcome of a certain situation? Like I say, it don't matter what it is. You assume it to be true. And you do that with affirmations and imagining it being how you want it to be over and over and over again until your subconscious mind believes it. And once your subconscious mind believes it, it's going to manifest how it's supposed to. Just try it. These aren't tactics that just work for me. These are things that work for other people too. I get emails all the time. It's like, hey, Amber, I'm going to put this testimonial like here. It says, I got an email. This is not too long ago. Hey, Amber, I got your whole LOA, Law of Attraction, help me bundle. And so far, I've manifested $14,300, a great conversation with my ex, a $5,000 scratch-off winner, and a change in my appearance. I lost 13 pounds. Let me get another one right quick. I just want to end this video on something positive, something you can look forward to. Hopefully, you subscribe to my channel and watch my other videos because I'm giving insight on all of this stuff, how to make your life easier. I'm gonna put this one here. It says, finally manifested is the subject. No long story here, finally manifested the 150,000 I told you about. Well, actually $159,433. About to go print out another copy of your scripting worksheets and fill it out for my next goal. P.S. You need to raise the prices. Seriously, dude. And the reason why I have my stuff so low is so more people can access it. Speaking of my scripting sheets, if you see any copy, I don't care if it's one page of my scripting sheets, somewhere else, Etsy, whatever, come and tell me. It's already, I've caught a couple stores that have literally word for word, bar for bar, copied my stuff and put it in theirs. Like I've had these for a couple years now. Like it's mind-blowing. And also I got an email the other day. I'm about to end this video, but I got an email the other day, just so you know, I haven't co-signed anybody on this here earth that is doing love spells for people. Apparently people are taking my videos and saying, hey, I did a love spell for her and she got her ex back and stuff like that. I'm like, yo, that don't have nothing to do with me. They take my videos and just put whatever under it. Don't send nobody no money. And people in my comments, they don't have nothing to do with me either. All of my stuff is going to be linked in my description box. But anyway, I'm Amber with thelovegal.com and youtube.com/thelovegal and lawofattractionblueprint.com. If you find any of this information useful, go ahead and give this video a thumbs up. And don't forget to drop an emoji in the comments. How are you feeling today? I want to know.